that is the solution of using rayon. If you want to ask more that, might as well interview Mr. Rayon.
Is that something for the DIC can do or private sector?
What else?
Yung mga solutions.
Actually, these are solutions yet. Once we are able to agree on it, we present it to the president and also the Department of Transportation for them to implement it. Because this is really not our service. Yes, ang gagawa nito is the DOTR, we are just going to recommend solutions. Functional ngayon. This is apart from our own talagang duties under the zone of the president in the broadband, Wi-Fi, and then the portal, and then our responsibilities under the law. But this, ito yung mga solutions pa. And we will recommend this to the DOTR. Mahal na sila matutunan. Wala pa. We presented it to Malacanang on October 3, first week of October. And we are awaiting the decision of the president on the type of broadband that we are going to establish in the country. Whether it is a pure physical broadband, number two, whether it is a working broadband to be used by the government and the people in the countryside, which are answered by the telcos, or it would it be a full-blown third-party operator. But my suggestion is try number two only. And then from there, decide if we want to venture into a full-blown operator.
But when you say full-blown operator, kayo, sir, yung,
yes,
kayo yung government, yes, will compete with that.
Yes,
monitor.
Yes. But again, I said, be careful, because if you do that, you must first have a feasibility study. Pag-aralan na ike. Pag-aralan na ike. Because when Republicans...
Ladies and gentlemen, please settle down. The program will resume in 5 minutes.
The law precisely is to privatize the provisioning of basic services like telecoms. So that is the intent of that public service.
Yes, sir, how much do you think it's going to cost in case we go for
cost?
Opo. Mayroon kayo minention before that.
Hindi pa ang laro eh. Panglaro. But the cost will depend on the details. I'd rather hold on muna to the costs. Because if we are going to have that cost at zero component, meaning wala tayong existing infrastructure na gagamitin. I was given this estimate of something like 77 billion to 110 billion pesos. A working broadband.
That's like, for number two. For number two. Okay. And then for the others, like for number three, sir,
we didn't ask anymore.
No more. Any target area, sir, that could be reached by your number three?
North to south.
Where,
and
missionary
countryside. Areas answered. And government. Where government is, we will be there because we want precisely to have an integrated network.
Do you already have like a meeting, like a schedule with the president, so you can get feedback on ano yung gusto niya?
We will just communicate to the president. For the time being, we are now fleshing out, putting details into the broadband plan, anticipating that it could be type 2. And then before we finalize it, we will be talking with also the stakeholders.
So that would have two players.
Those who are involved somehow in the provision of the program. So anyone who has an idea, we will invite them to have the program.
Kasama na po pa dyan yung program ng ICPO dati na free Wi-Fi connection.
Itong broadband will work side by side with the Wi-Fi because kung tutuusin mo yan, a Wi-Fi can be considered as a component of the broadband. So, side by side with the broadband, we have the Wi-Fi, but even as we are yet to implement the broadband, yung Wi-Fi natin, naglalatag na tayo. So that by 2016, we intend to put up something like 1,300 100 plus Wi-Fi sites.
That was years ago.
In 2017, mga 1,000, another 1,800 sites. Up to 2026, for 10 years from now, we want to put up about 100,000 Wi-Fi sites. This is to provide connectivity and connectivity and coverage to those areas which do not have connectivity.
Secretary, when you said you're going to submit their proposal to the Department of Transportation, so does it mean that you're working independently on the ICT-based solutions? So wala nakasit in taga DOTR?
Nandito, may nakaupo nga sila diyan.
So meron during the...
During the first, during the pre-summit, they were already present.
So
I personally invited them.
So kasama sila all throughout?
And their inputs are also welcome here because at the end of the day, itong input namin, natin, bibigay natin sa kanila. They are not necessarily bound by their input because they are the primary department in charge of the
transportation
situations in the country. So ours is clearly a contribution.
Okay.